This video is going to be about solving absolute value equations and inequalities. And in case you're not familiar with absolute value, I want to take a couple of minutes and go over that first before we get to the actual equations. Here I've written negative 4 plus 1, and that negative 4 plus 1 is in between these two upright lines. And then I've got equals 3. This is an absolute value equation, and we read this as the absolute value of negative 4 plus 1 equals 3. The way absolute value works is whatever is in between the absolute value signs, you evaluate that. So I evaluate negative 4 plus 1, and I get a negative 3. And then whatever your answer is, you make it positive. So negative 4 plus 1 is negative 3. I make it positive, and I can write equals 3. If it's already positive, like 2 plus 1, then I don't have to change anything. So the absolute value of 2 plus 1 equals 3. If you've got a variable, let's say you've got the absolute value of x equals 5. Well, what I know is x could have been a positive number or a negative number. So basically, the absolute value of x equals 5 means that x equals 5 or x equals negative 5. In other words, there are two values for x which would make the absolute value of x equal to 5. Now, a lot of calculators will have absolute value functions. If you've got something like a TI-83 or a TI-84, here's how you're going to get to it. Go to the button marked Math. So you're going to press the Math button. And then you'll get a new window. And one of the options there will be num for number. And when you look down the number menu, one of the options is going to be ABS for absolute or absolute value, and there'll be parentheses after it. When you press that, you can take whatever you want to find the absolute value of and put it inside the parentheses. So if I've had absolute value of negative 4 plus 1 and pressed enter, the calculator would tell me that that equaled 3. Okay? So make sure you're comfortable with that if you haven't used that yet. And now I'm going to go on and we're going to look at actually solving absolute value equations and inequalities. Okay, so let's say we're starting out and we've got this problem. The absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3, and we're told to solve it graphically. Well, here's what we're going to do. On a graphing calculator, we're going to go to the y equals window. You know, we have y sub 1 and y sub 2 and y sub 3. And under y sub 1, we're going to enter the absolute value. In other words, the left side of that equation. So I've got y sub 1 equals abs, and then the expression x minus 2. And I've done that in red. I just want to keep these two equations separate with colors. And then we're going to enter under y sub 2, which I've done in green, the right side of the equation. So I've got y sub 2 equals 3. And then if you graph it, you're going to get a graph that looks something like this. Okay? So here's how we're going to use the graph to solve the problem. Let me write the problem right here. The absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3. Well, you know, if these were just regular linear equations, what I would do is look for the place where the two, like a system of equations, I would look for the place where the two graphs cross, and that would be my solutions. Well, since absolute values can have positive and negative solutions, in other words, there's probably two answers to what x could be, there are probably going to be two answers for the absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3. So we're going to look at the two places where the graphs cross. And then we can use the intersect function on the calculator, and we'll find that this place on the left where they cross, where the red absolute value V crosses the horizontal y equals 3 line, and I'm going to find that that point is negative 1, comma 3. And it makes sense that I've got 3 for the second part of my ordered pair, because I've got this horizontal line going across at y equals 3. If I look at the right side of the graph to find the second answer, I'm going to find that that has an intersection at the point 5, comma 3. And again, the 3 is kind of predictable. Okay, so I've got these two intersection points, negative 1, comma 3, and 5, comma 3. And I want to solve the problem, the absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3. Well, you notice in that equation, there's no y. All I'm doing is trying to figure out what the x could be. So I'm going to disregard the y values, the 3s, in my ordered pairs. And my answer is just going to be x equals negative 1 or x equals 3. I'm sorry, 5. Okay, actually, let's take a second and check those two answers. Let's look at this equation. The absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3. Well, if I plug in negative 1, I have negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3. I'll disregard the negative now. So the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. If I have use the 5, 5 minus 2 is also 3. So the absolute value of 3 is 3. So both, I know both of these solutions will work. So I've got them written here. And if you're told to graph your solutions on a number line, you know, here's something kind of neat. A number line is really, in a sense, maybe just your x-axis. So I'm going to copy the x-axis. And when I graph this, I'll put a dot at negative 1, and I'll put a dot at 5, and that's exactly where on my original x-axis, by looking up from that axis, I find the intersections. Okay? I also want to talk about inequalities. When we have something like the absolute value of x minus 2 is greater than 3, but I think I'm going to save that for a second video. So stick around, I'll be right back.